We're asked to use long division to find the quotient. But for this example, instead of using the traditional long division algorithm, we'll use the method of partial quotients. The first step is to write the quotient in long division form, which is this form here. So we'll write this quotient as 4,756 divided by 8. When using the partial quotients method, we'll draw a vertical line to the right to keep our work organized. We'll write the partial quotients on the right side. Now to begin the process of partial quotients, we always consider the entire dividend, in this case 4,756, and because we're dividing by 8, we want to determine a certain number of 8s that we know for sure are in 4,756. To help us do this, let's show some work. Let's say we know that 5 times 8 is equal to 40. We want to find a product, so because this product is less than the dividend, we know there's at least 5/8 in our dividend, but we want to find a product that's much closer to the dividend, that's not more than the dividend. So if 5 times 8 equals 40, we should be able to recognize that 50 times 8 is equal to 400. Since 50 is 10 times more than 5, 50 times 8 is 10 times more than 5 times 8. And if 50 times 8 is equal to 400, 500 times 8 is equal to 4,000. Notice how 4,000 is still less than the dividend of 4,756. And therefore, we know the dividend contains at least 500/8. So let's use 500 as our first partial quotient. So we'll write 500 here on the right. Now we'll multiply by the divisor. We know 500 times 8 is 4,000. We write 4,000 below the dividend, and we subtract. The difference is 756. And now we repeat the process. We want to determine a certain number of 8s that we know for sure are in 756. Well, we know that 50 times 8 is equal to 400, because 400 is less than 756. We know 756 has at least 50/8, so let's use 50 as the next partial quotient. So write down 50 on the right, multiply by the divisor. 50 times 8 is 400. We subtract. So we have 6, 5, 3. So the difference is 356. Repeating the process, we need to find a certain number of 8s that we know for sure are in 356. So because 50 times 8 is equal to 400, we might recognize that 25 times 8 would have to be equal to 200. So we could use a partial quotient of 25, but let's try a different approach. Because we know that 4 times 8 is equal to 32, then 40 times 8 must be equal to 320. Notice 320 is closer to 356 than 200, so let's use 40 as the next partial quotient. So we'll record a 40 on the right, multiply by the divisor, 40 times 8 is 320. We subtract. Notice the difference is going to be 36, and we repeat the process. We want to determine a certain number of 8s that we know for sure are in 36. Well, 4 times 8 is equal to 32. Because 32 is less than 36, we know there's at least 4 8s in 36. Let's use 4 as the next partial quotient. 4 times 8 again is 32. We subtract, and notice how the difference is 4. And because 4 is less than the divisor of 8, we're done. We just need to interpret the results. This 4 is a remainder, and the sum of these partial quotients will give us our quotient. So let's go ahead and find the sum here on the right. So we have 4 in the ones, a 9 in the tens, and a 5 in the hundreds. So our answer is 594 with the remainder of 4. So the nice thing about the partial quotients method is that there's not only one way to find the quotient. We can use any known products involving the divisor to find partial quotients, which we can then use to find the actual quotient. Notice that here we do have a remainder. We which tells us several things. First, it tells us 8 is not a factor of 4,756, and it also tells us that the quotient of 594 times the divisor of 8 plus the remainder of 4 equals the dividend of 4,756. Let's go ahead and simplify the left side. 594 times 8 is equal to 4,752. And notice how if we add 4, we do get 4,756. I hope you found this helpful.